Hello friends, welcome to my channel Civil Engineering MCQ. In this video, we will discuss about most important multiple choice questions in surveying subject. This video helpful for PWD, WRD, RRB, JEE, MIDC, ZB exams, and it is also helpful for various competitive exams. So let's start. Question number first. Which of the following leveling is carried out to determine the elevation difference between two points on the surface of Earth? This question is asked to exam PWD 2018. Right option D, simple leveling. Question number first, answer is D, simple leveling. It is carried out to determine the elevation difference between two points on surface of Earth, and it is conducted when distance between the two stations is less. Right option D, simple leveling. Differential leveling, conducted when distance between the two points is high. In this leveling, position of instrument is changed multiple number of times. Third one, C, reciprocal leveling. In simple leveling, instrument placed in between two stations so that foresight and backsight are balanced. D, longitudinal leveling, profile leveling. In this method, staff readings are taken along the alignment. Question number 2. The first stage of engineering surveys for highway location is? This question is asked to exam PWD 2018. Right option C, map study. Question number 2. Answer is C, stages in engineering surveys. First one, map study. Second one, recognized study. Third one, preliminary study. Last one, final location and detailed survey. So correct option C. Question number 3. In reduced bearing system, the bearing is measured. This question is also asked to exam PWD 2018. Correct option A, clockwise or anti-clockwise from north or south towards east or west. Question number 3. Answer is A, reduced bearing system. Bearing are measured from north or south direction towards east or west. Hence angle are 0 degree to 90 degree Celsius. It is used in surveyor compass and also known as quadrantile bearing QB, clockwise or anti-clockwise from north or south towards east or west. So correct option A. Question number 4. Regarding difficulties faced in leveling while leveling across a depression. Correct option A, the level should be set up on one side and not at the bottom of the depression. Question number 4th, answer is A, difficulties faced in leveling. First one, when the staff is close to the instrument, in this case the instrument loses its focus and become blur. It's solved by white paper. Hold the staff vertical and white paper is slowly moved up and down in front of it. Second one, leveling across a large lake. In this case, some assumptions are made. Point C, leveling across a solid wall. In this case, two pegs are driven on both sides of wall at the staff just touching the wall. Now find HI measured by focusing any benchmark. Point D, benchmark lies above line of collimation. Point E, leveling along a steep slope. It resolved by position depression level set up in zigzag path. Point F, leveling across depression or rising ground. In this case, instrument should not kept at a peak or lowest of ground. In case of depression, the instrument is positioned at one side of depressed portion and staff is positioned at other side of depression. So correct option A. Question number 5. Consider the following statements. X equal to at change point, backsight and foresight readings are taken from the same sitting. Y equal to backsight reading is always taken on a point of known reduced level. Which of the following statements is or are true? Correct option C, both X and Y. Number 5th, answer is C, change point. A point at which FS and VS readings are taken from same sitting. Backside, it is the side taken with the level to the point of X, is known as elevation E of X, so that height of instrument can be found. So right answer C. Question number 6. Open cross staff is used for setting out. Correct option A. Long offsets. Question number 6. Answer is A. Open cross staff. It consists of a long staff with a perpendicular vane. Features. First one, used to measure the altitude of the sun. Second one, used as navigation instrument. Third one, wind resistance and fire coating. And the last one, used to setting out long offset. So correct option A. Question number 7. In which of the following method traversing by a fast needle is performed? Right option C. Theodolite traversing. Question number 7. Answer is C. There are 3 methods of traversing. First one, by chain angle method, chain traversing. Second one, free loose needle method. Third one, fast needle method. First one explanation, by chain angle method and chain traversing, entire work is done with chain tape only and angle between the successive lines is measured with chain. Second one, free and loose needle method. Angular measurement such as a compass or theodolite is set up at each successive station and the bearing of each lines is taken with reference to the magnetic meridian. The last one method of traversing, fast needle method. Theodolite is used to determine the bearing of each line. So correct option C. Question number 8. Sometimes for the survey of a small area, convenient direction is assumed as meridian, known as correct option C, arbitrary meridian. Question number 8. Answer is C, meridian. Bearing of a line is always measured clockwise with respect to some reference lines or direction is called as meridian. There are 3 types of meridian. First one, magnetic meridian. Second one, true meridian. And the third one, arbitrary meridian. First one, magnetic meridian. Definition: the direction shown by a freely suspended needle is known as magnetic meridian. Second one, true meridian. It is the line which passes through the true north and south. Third one, arbitrary meridian. In case of a small work or in places where true meridian, magnetic meridian cannot be determined, then any direction of prominent object is taken to a reference called as arbitrary meridian. So right option C. Question number 9. What is called a level line? Right option D. The line is parallel to the main spheroidal surface of Earth. Question number 9. Answer is D. Level line. It is the distance between 2 points on the level surface which follows the curvature of the Earth. So right option D. Question number 10. The imaginary line passing through the optical center of the object glass and the optical center of the eyepiece is called. Right option C. Axis of telescope. Question number 10. Answer is C. Axis of telescope. It is the line of passing through the center of all optical elements. Datum line. A standard of comparison or point of reference. Question number 11. Which of the following type of chain is suitable for measuring distances along fairly level ground? Correct option A. Metric chain. Question number 11. Answer is A. There are 4 types of chain. First one, metric chain. Second one, Gunter's and surveyor's chain. Third one, engineer's chain. Fourth one, revenue chain. First one, metric chain, used for measuring distance along fairly level ground, 20 meter and 30 meter. Gunter's chain and surveyor's chain, used for measuring distance in miles, furlongs or acres, length equal to 66 feet and number of links equal to 100. Third one type, engineer's chain, used in all engineer's surveys, length equal to 100 feet, number of links equal to 100. Fourth one, renewable chain, commonly used for measuring fields in cadastral surveys. So right option A. Question number 12. In a closed traverse, right option C, sum of included angles should be 2n minus 4 times right angles, where n equal to number of sides. Question number 12. Answer is C. A closed traverse, when a line from a circuit which ends at the starting point, it is known as closed traverse. Sum of included angles should be 2n minus 4 times right angles, where n equal to number of sides. So right option C. Question number 13. Chain surveying is suitable when? Right option D. The formation of well-conditioned triangles is easy. Number 13, answer is D. Chain surveying is suitable, most suitable adopted to a small plain areas with very few details. Formation of well-conditioned triangles is easy. Right option D. Question number 14. The angle which the true meridian makes with magnetic meridians is called right option C. Magnetic declination or declination. Question number 14. Answer is C. First one, magnetic declination or declination. It is the angle on horizontal plane between magnetic north and true north. Second one, azimuth. An azimuth is the angular measurement in a spherical coordinate system, also known as true bearing. So right option C. Third one, deep. Deep angle and magnetic inclination is the angle made with the horizontal by earth magnetic field lines. So right option C. Question number 15. The leveling instrument for the elimination of collimation error must be placed. Right option C. Exactly midway between the BS and FS. Question number 15. Answer is C. Collimation error. It can be almost entirely eliminated by carefully balancing the foresight length with the backsight length. Right option C. Question number 16. If the quadrilateral bearing system of a line is 320 degree 30 seconds, the reduced bearing of the line will be. Right option A. North 39 degree 30 seconds west. Question number 16. Answer is A. 360 degree minus 320 degree 30 seconds equal to 39 degree 30 seconds north 39 degree 30 seconds west. Right option A. Question number 17. While chaining on sloping ground by indirect method, the slope is measured by. Right option A. Clinometer. Question number 17. Answer is A. Slope is measured by clinometer. When sighting through a clinometer, the measuring line is placed on the target and percentage slope is read from the scale. Both eyes are open as one eye is read the scale and other eye is sight on the target. So right option A. Question number 18. The reference location are generally choose to close the day's work and to start the next day's point on roofs, wall, basement, etc. Right option C. Arbitrary benchmark. Question number 18. Answer is C. There are four types of benchmark. First one, GTS, Great Trigonometric Survey benchmark. Second one, permanent benchmark. Third one, arbitrary benchmark. And fourth one, temporary benchmark. First one, GTS, long form is Great Trigonometric Survey benchmark. They established with high degree of precision at regular intervals by Survey of India Department all over country. Second one, permanent benchmark. These are fixed points or marked established by government departments like PWD, Railway. Right option C. Third one, arbitrary benchmark. When areas of some fixed points are assumed, they are termed arbitrary benchmark. These adopted for small areas. Fourth one, temporary benchmark. When the benchmark is established temporary at the end of day's work, they are said to be temporary benchmark. So right option C. Question number 19. The benchmark fixed at the end of day's work is called as. Right answer option A. Temporary benchmark. Number 19. Answer is A. Temporary benchmark. When the benchmark are established temporarily at the end of day's work, they are said to be temporary benchmark. So right option A. Question number 20. The sign of slope correction and sag correction applied to tape error are. Right option D. Both negative. Question number 20. Answer is D. In the formula of slope correction equal to minus S square upon 2L, sag correction minus W square L cube upon 24P square. Right option D. Question number 21. The reference location are assumed on the basis of some fixed points. Right option C. Arbitrary benchmark. 21. Answer is C. Arbitrary benchmark. When reduced level of some fixed points are assumed, they are termed arbitrary benchmark. These adopted for a small areas. Right option C. Question number 22. A line is considered as free from local attraction in quadrilateral bearing system if the fore bearing and back bearing of the line are. Right option C. Numerical equal with opposite sign.
Number 22, answer is C. In quadrilateral bearing, the line is considered free from local attraction if north versus south, east versus west, BB equal to FB plus minus 180 degrees Celsius. So right option of C. Question number 23, which of the following surveying is conducted in order to determine the boundaries of field, estate and houses? Right option B, cadastral surveying. Question number 23, answer is B, cadastral surveying. It is used to establishment and re-establishment of real properties boundaries. Right option B. Second one, topographical surveying. It is the survey that gathers data about the elevation of points on a piece of land and presents them as contour lines on a plot. The purpose of this is to collect survey data about natural and man-made features of land as well as its elevation. So correct option B. Question number 24. The last staff reading in any setup of instrument is called right option A, foresight. Number 24, answer A, foresight. It is the staff reading taken on a point whose elevation is to be determined as on change point. Second one, backsight. It is the staff reading taken on a point of known elevation as on a benchmark of a change point. So correct option A. Third one, intermediate sight. All sights taken between the backsight and foresight are called as intermediate sight. Question number 25. To obtain the correct volume using trapezoidal rule and prismodal correction should always be right option B, subtracted. Question number 25. Answer is B, trapezoidal formula. V equal to H upon 2 A1 plus AN plus 2 bracket madhe A2 plus A3 plus AN minus 1 bracket close. Prismodal correction should be subtractive. Right option B.
Question number 26, azimuth is also known as right option A, true bearing. Question number 26, answer is A, azimuth is an angle between 0 degree and 360 degree measured clockwise from north. So right answer option A. Question number 27, the bearing of line measured in the direction of progress of the survey is called right option A, forebearing. One, grid bearing. Grid bearing is a major bearing using the direction of northwards along the grid lines of map projection as a reference point. Second one, true bearing. It is a measured using the direction toward the geographic north pole as a reference point. Third one, magnetic bearing. It is the bearing is measured in relation to magnetic north using the direction toward magnetic north pole as a reference point. So right option A. Question number 28. The general principle of surveying is, first one, to work from part of whole. Second one, to locate a new station by at least two measurement, linear or angular, from fixed references points. Right option B, second only. Question number 28. Answer is B. General principle of surveying, first one, to work from whole to part. Second one, to locate a new station by at least two measurements, linear or angular, from fixed references points. So right option B. Question number 29. The leveling done at the end of day's work to connect the finishing point with the starting point on that particular day is called right option D, check leveling. Question number 29. Answer is D, check leveling. This kind of leveling is carried out to check the accuracy of work. It is done at the end of day's work in the form of fly leveling to connect the finishing point and starting point. So right option of D. Question number 30. The object of surveying is to prepare a, the right option A, map. Question number 30. Answer is A. Object of surveying, to prepare a map or plan to represent an area on a horizontal plan. So right option A. Question number 31. Which of the following is the correct sequence for the stages of the engineering surveys? This question is asked to exam assistant town planning 2018. Right option D, map study, recognize preliminary survey, final location and detailed surveys. question number 31. Answer is D. Stages in engineering surveys. First one, map study. Second one, recognized study. Third one, preliminary study. And the last one, final location and detailed survey. So right option D. Question number 32. Which one of the following is not a type of benchmark? Correct option D, direct benchmark. Number 32, answer is D. Type of benchmark, first one, GTS, long form is Great Trigonometrical Survey Benchmark. They established with a high degree of precision at regular interval by a survey of India, department all over country. Second one, permanent benchmark. These are fixed points or marks established by government departments like a PWD, railway. Right option D. Third one, arbitrary benchmark. When a reduced level of some fixed points are assumed, they are termed arbitrary benchmark. These adopted for a small areas. Last one, temporary benchmark. When the benchmark are established temporarily, at the end of day's work, they are said to be temporary benchmark. So right option D. Question number 33. Escape velocity of satellite is given by. This question is also asked to exam Nagar Parichat pre 2018. So right option D, both A and B. Question number 33. Answer is D. Escape velocity of a satellite V equal to under root of 2gr V equal to under root of gm upon r plus h. Question number 34. Hyposometric leveling is. Right option C. Determination of elevation of various point with respect to change in boiling point of water. 34. Answer is C. Hyposometric leveling. The working of hyposometric for determining the elevation depends upon the temperature at which water boils varies with the atmospheric pressure. So right option C. The boiling point of water reduces at a higher altitude, thus knowing the boiling point of water, the atmospheric pressure can be calculated. The knowing the atmospheric pressure, altitude or elevation can be determined. So right option C. Question number 35. Which of the following method of plane table surveying is suitable for establishing new points at place in order to locate missing details? This question is asked to exam Nagar Parichad Mains 2018. Right option D, section D. Question number 35. Answer is D. Method of plane table. First one, method of radiation. It is suitable for a plotting of small area which can be commanded from a single station. Second one, method of intersection. It is commonly employed for locating the distant and inaccessible points, locating the broken boundaries and the point which may be used as instrument station. So right answer D. Third one, method of traversing. It is used for running survey lines between stations which have been previously fixed by other method of surveying to locate topographic details. It is also used for roads and rivers, etc. Fourth one, resection. This method is used for establishing instrument station. Question number 36. The minimum number of ranging rods required for direct and indirect ranging are. Right option C, 3 and 4 respectively. Question number 36. Answer is C. At least 3 ranging rod required for direct ranging and at least 4 ranging rod required for indirect ranging. So right option C. Question number 37. Which one of the following is the correct sequence of various stages of engineering surveys? Right option A. Map study, recognize, preliminary, final location and detailed survey. Question number 37. Answer is A. These are stages in engineering surveys. First one, map study. Second one, recognized study. Third one, preliminary study. And the last one, final location and detailed survey. So right option A. Question number 38. Autoclave test conducted in laboratory is used to determine. This question is asked to exam Kolhapur MNC 2017. Right option A, soundness of cement. Question number 38. Answer is A. Soundness test of cement by autoclave apparatus. The Lee Chartier test detects unsoundness due to free lime only. As per IS specification, if the content of magnesia greater than 3% in cement, then autoclave test is performed. which is sensitive both lime and magnesium. So right option A. Question number 39. Two contours of different elevation don't cross each other except in case of. This question is asked to exam Chandrapuri MNC 2017. Right option B. Overhanging cliff. Question number 39. Answer is B. Overhanging cliff. Contours of different elevation intersect with each other. Second one, hill lake. Elevation increase from outside to inside. Third one, pond. Elevation decrease from outside to inside. Correct option B. Question number 40. To locate the position of inaccessible points, which method of plane table surveying is used? Right option D. Method of intersection. Question number 40. Answer is D. Method of intersection. It is commonly employed for locating the distant and inaccessible points, locating the broken boundaries and the point which may be used in instrument station. Right option B. Question number 41. To transfer point to ground or first centering, the instrument used in surveying is. Correct option B. Plug bob. Question number 41. Answer is B. To locate fixtures or decoration in relation to an object or surface below using the plumb line. To transfer point to ground or first centering the instrument. Right option B. Question number 42. The most suitable method of contouring for a hilly area is. Right option A. Tachometric method. Question number 42. Answer is A. Method of contouring. There are two types of method of contouring. First one, direct method. Second one, indirect method. Direct method using for small and important of work. Indirect method, there are three types. First one, grid. Second one, cross sectional. And third one, tachometric. First one, grid for using large areas. Second one, cross sectional for canals and embankment. And third one, tachometric, highly suitable for hilly areas. So right option A. Question number 43. For the measurement of angles of slope, instrument used is. Right option B. Clinometer. Question number 43. Answer is B. Slope is measured by clinometer. A clinometer can be used to measure heights of trees, poles, towers and buildings. You can also use it to measure slope for preliminary surveying, grade work and site drainage. So right answer B. Question number 44. An arbitrary surface with respect to which the elevation of points are measured is. Right option D. Datum surface. Question number 44. Answer is D. First one, datum surface. References plan with respect to which reduced level of the other survey points is determined. It is used in surveying and building with a vertical staff to measure height differences and to transfer measure and set heights. So right option D. Second one, level surface. It is the continuous surface parallel to the mean spheroidal of the earth. The line representing the level surface is called level line. So right option D. Question number 45. Contour intervals is defined as. Correct option D. The vertical distance between two consecutive contours. Question number 45. Answer is D. It is the vertical distance between two consecutive contours is called as contour intervals. Factors affecting contour interval. First one, scale of map increases, then contour interval decreases. Second one, flatness increases, then contour interval decreases. Third one, importance increases, then contour interval decreases. Fourth one, fund increases, then contour interval decreases. Fifth one, time increases, then contour interval decreases. The last one, slope increases, then contour interval increases. So right option D. Question number 46. The plane table method suitable to establish a station with respect to the pre-established station is nearby. Vicinity is the method of. This question is asked to exam WRD 2016. Right option C. Resection. Question number 46. Answer is C. Resection. This method is used for establishing instrument station. Question number 47. FB of line QR corrected for local attraction is 358 degree 45 second. Its observed BB is 177 degree 15 second. Then correction for local attraction at station R will be right option C, minus 1 degree 30 second. Question number 47, answer is C. The difference between fore bearing and back bearing equal to 180 degree Celsius. So keep these values FB minus BB equal to 350 degree 45 second minus 177 degree 15 second equal to 181 degree 30 second. Error equal to 181 degree 30 second minus 180 degree equal to 1 degree 30 second. Your values come correction equal to minus 1 degree 30 second. So correct option C. Question number 48. Electronic total station instrument generates the survey data is format. Right option B, digital. 48. Answer is B. Electronic total station. A total station is modern survey instrument that integrates an electronic theodolite with an electronic distance meter. It uses electronic transit theodolite in conjunction with a distance meter to read any slope distance from instrument to any particular spot. It generates survey data in digital format. Right option B. Question number 49. VS1CP is 2.105 meter and IS1 staff station immediate next to that CP is 1.370, then there will be dash from the CP to that IS station. Right option C, rise of 0.735 meter. Question number 49, answer is C. VS of CP equal to 2.105 meter. IS next to CP equal to 1.370 meter. Rise upon fall equal to 2.105 minus 1.370 equal to 0.735 meter. Rise equal to 0.735 meter. So right option C. Question number 50. Independent north coordinate of station B is 54 meter. Latitude of BC is 6 meter southing. Then independent north coordinate of station C will be dash. Right option A, 48 meter. Question number 50. Answer is A. North coordinate of station B is 54 meter and latitude of BC is 6 meter southing. North coordinate of station C equal to 54 minus 6 equal to 48 meter. Right option A. In this video, last question 51. A set of closed contour loops on a plan or map with contour elevation decreasing towards their common center indicates. Right option A, pond. Question number 51. Answer is A. First one, overhanging cliff. Contours of different elevation intersect with each other. Second one, B, hillock. Elevation increase from outside to inside. Third one, pond. Elevation decrease from outside to inside. Right option A. Here this video is finished. I hope this video will be helpful for your exam. For more updates, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends. Thank you so much.